In this video, I will explain working and construction of field effect transistors. Field effect transistors are in fact voltage control devices. They are unipolar in nature and they have three terminals. Field effect transistors come in various forms. The very first one is junction field effect transistor. In this transistor, we use one p-n junction and we always reverse bias the p-n junction to control the depth or the width of conducting channel through the device. And this is called MES, effective metal semiconductor field effect transistor. In this transistor, we replace p-n junction by Schottky barrier diode. And this is MIS, effective metal insulator semiconductor field effect transistor. In this case, the metallic gate is separated from semiconductor by insulator. And when that insulator is replaced by oxide, then it is called MOSFET. This is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. These field effect transistors are basically used for amplification and switching purpose. Let me explain the basic skeleton or fundamental diagram of one junction field effect transistor. In this case, I am considering one N-channel field effect transistor, and this is the symbol for NFET. This is the gate terminal, and this is the drain, and this is the source terminal, and current is passing from drain to source. And these are two parts of gate region, and these two parts are internally connected and electrically connected also. And this is drain and this is the source region. And this part is basically channel. By applying reverse biasing through gate terminal, we establish an electric field perpendicular to this channel. And this reverse biasing changes the depth and other the width of this conducting channel. That means resistance of conducting channel increases, and that's why current decreases. That's why this device is called field effect transistor, because that field which is generated by applying reverse biasing through gate terminal controls the current passing through the device, in this case from drain to source. I'm discussing NFET. So this is basically the most fundamental way of saying how this works. As I was discussing the working of junction field effect transistor, any junction field effect transistor contains one p-n junction. Before discussing the operation and working of junction field effect transistor, let us see what happens when we apply reverse biasing across any normal p-n junction. This is the cross-section area of p-n junction. This part is p, and this is the n region. And these are two regions containing acceptor and donor current, and these are immobile charges, and these are the concentration of acceptor and donor ions across these two regions. And this dotted line, this one and this one, these are the boundaries of depletion region across junction W, and this gap is called the width of total depletion region across a junction. And this is a simple equation by which we can determine the extent or total depth across junction. And here this V naught is contact potential, V is applied potential, and it is negative for reverse biasing in this case. And Na and Nd are concentration of immobile charges, acceptor and donor ions. In N type junction field effect transistors, we have heavily doped P plus region. In that case, Na is far greater than Nd. We apply this inequality to this equation. We get very simplistic equation for W. Here, I assume this thing also, applied potential is far greater than contact potential. Here, we see one thing, Nd is smaller compared to Na. W is more. And if you see here, I am converting this for N-type junction field effect transistor, where P is replaced by P plus, and the whole W will be penetrating more in N-type region, lightly doped region. That means this dotted line may be shifted downward this way. This line will be very dear to junction region. And resulting width will be this. Whole thing will be shifted downward and more penetration in lightly doped region. This will be downward. We can neglect this part, this region, this depletion region, which is penetrating into heavily doped region. And the whole philosophy of understanding this type of operation is, in junction field effect transistor, we have a conducting channel here. This is a conducting channel. And this depletion region is penetrating in the conducting channel. And in this way, the cross-section area of this conducting channel reduces or reduced by penetration of depletion region. And reduction of cross-section area or depth of conducting channel means its resistance is increasing and current starts decreasing. That's why the name implies this is called voltage control device. Apply voltage appropriate. In this case, reverse biasing. Establish one electric field and catalytic field simply pushes depletion region into the conducting channel and indirectly we control the current passing through the device. And this is the next part in understanding the working of JFET. And this is the cross section area of N-type JFET, source, gate and drain terminals. And this part is lightly doped N-type channel. And these two regions are heavily doped P plus gate region. Let us see what happens when we apply potential to these terminals. For example, at gate, we apply reverse biasing minus VGS. And this is P plus heavily doped region. We see in this region, the moment we apply gate potential, the whole region will show equipotential region. And everywhere, at each point, potential will be same. And in this case, when we apply VDS, this is lightly doped, and we find there is a potential gradient here. This way, this is a shape of potential gradient. Higher at side and lower at this side. Now, what would be the reverse biasing? And this will be minus VGD and equivalent to VDG. We see here one important point. The effect of reverse biasing will be more near the drain end compared to the source end. And this fact is in fact very useful in studying and the effect of reverse biasing would be more at the drain end. Here we see one thing, the effect of reverse biasing will be more near the drain end compared to the source end. And this fact is in fact very useful in understanding the shape of depletion region and the penetration of depletion region inside the conducting channel. And this point we will be discussing on the next page. On this page, I will discuss how depletion region extends or penetrates into N channel, especially in the case of N channel junction field effect transistor. Cross section area of JFET with N channel. In this case, gate and source terminals are at zero potential. We apply very small drain to source potential. We see here for a smaller voltage, a smaller current flows, and they are having linear relationship. For a smaller VDS, the width of depletion region is almost uniform. That means the conducting channel is of rectangular shape, parallel shape. The moment we are increasing VDS, current start increasing, but it doesn't follow linear path. Current is decreasing. That means somewhat in some other way, the resistance of conducting channel must be increasing. See how it happens. I told you on the last page, the effect of reverse biasing is much more near the drain end compared to the source end. That's why depletion region penetrates more into the conducting channel near the drain end compared to the source end. That's why the shape of depletion region is not parallel, it is wedge shape. And this area is smaller than this area. That means resulting resistance of conducting channel increases. That's why current starts decreasing, not following linear path. At higher potential VDS, we observe one very particular condition. The depletion region extending from the top and depletion region from the bottom extending again in the conducting channel. They start touching each other and the shape of conducting channel transforms from parallel to wedge to a triangular shape. That means at this point where depletion regions touch each other, the cross-section area of conducting channel becomes zero. That means at pinch of condition, the resistance or resulting resistance of conducting channel becomes maximum or current doesn't increase much beyond this point, and this point is called saturation point. Case when we start increasing VDS, we come across very particular point where the depletion region from this part and depletion from this part, they start touching each other. And at this point, the cross-section area of conducting channel becomes zero. That means in this case, the shape is changed from parallel to wedge to triangular shape. Cross-section area is zero. That means at this point, pinch of point, the resistance must be higher. And at this point, current stops increasing. And beyond this saturation point, this point is called saturation point, pinch off point. And beyond saturation point, current doesn't increase. And this is called saturation state. And this point depends entirely upon the combination of VDS and VGS. On the next page, I will tell you the relation between VDS and VGS, and we will calculate the value of any value of reverse biasing for which we get this situation. On this page, I'll be discussing pinch off voltage condition and determination of pinch off voltage for JFET N-type channel. This is the cross section area of JFET for N-type. On the last page, we applied some positive potential to the drain and keeping gate and source terminals at zero potential. At pinch off condition, what happens? The depletion region from the upper part and the lower part, they touch at the middle of the channel this way. This is the depletion region from the upper part. And this is from the lower part. And they touch at the middle of the channel. And this situation is known as pinch off condition. This happens at a particular combination of potential at D, G with respect to S. We define pinch of voltage Vp that is equal to V dG this way. It is nothing but the reverse bias voltage. And this is called the width of depletion region. It is maximum here. And width of depletion region can be determined by using this equation. Here, I can use this equation to find out the pinch of voltage, and this is pinch of voltage, and this W is equal to A. This is nothing but the half width. This is A. This is the half width or half metallurgical width of the conducting channel. This way, I can ensure the Vp comes out equal to this one, and this is very constant term entirely depending upon A. This is prefix and this is fixed by doping, and this is called pinch of voltage, and this is the equation for pinch of voltage. This shows the output characteristic of N channel junction field effect transistor, and this is the current passing through the device, and this is the potential difference between drain and source. For very first curve, gate was maintained at 0 volt, and this is the pinch off condition. When we increase reverse bias in this direction, more reverse bias, we are getting this pinch off condition at lower value of VDS. This is a way we can say gate is controlling net current passing through the device. Higher gate voltage in a reverse way means lower value of current. This is the direction of reduction in the current and reduction in the potential difference VDS. At the lower value of VDS, we can get the pinch off condition when gate potential is higher in terms of reverse biasing. This is the basic equation of controlling. This is reverse biasing. This changes the width of conducting channel and current can be controlled. And this is the basic definition of field effect transistors. You see, one important fact is there. The resistivity of conducting channel is fixed by lightly doped and as material is used there. You can't change this thing, but the resulting and working resistance of conducting channel is controlled by reverse biasing. The penetration of depletion region from both sides of gate part simply reduces the cross-section area of conducting channel, and the shape varies right from rectangle to wedge to a triangular shape. That means this way the effective resistance of conducting channel increases and current starts decreasing. That's why it's called field. A field of gate voltage is controlling current. This is the basic theory and fundamental of working of junction field effect transistor. One thing is very peculiar about this set of output characteristics. We see for equal increment in gate potential, the spacing between these characteristics are not same. The reason behind is that this current passing through the device does not linearly depend upon the potential difference across drain to source. On the next article, on the next page, I'll explain and derive the relationship between the current passing through the device and the potential difference across drain to source. In fact, the relationship between them is a square-law relationship. Let me explain the relationship between the current passing through the device and the potential difference applied across drain to source for N-type junction field effect transistor. This is three-dimensional diagram for a wedge-shaped conducting channel. And this wedge shape is the reason behind of being wedge shape I explained earlier. And I'm considering this is x-axis and this is y-axis, where this A is the half metallurgical width of conducting channel. And at distance x or x plus dx, there is a differential element of this conducting channel. And this is the width at this point. And this is the whole length of conducting channel. Considering this element, and this is the volume of this differential element, the resistance of this differential element is this much. And the current passing through this element means this whole current will be passing through the device. Whatever current is passing through this means the current is passing through the device as a whole. And this is the expression or current passing through the element or through the device. I am simplifying one thing here, this yx, this width in terms of A and W. W is the width of depletion region which is penetrating into the conducting channel and remaining only this part. This is reduced part compared to this part. And converting yx in terms of A and W using this constant value, and yx may be converted in this way. Further simplification is this much, then A1 minus Vxs minus Vgx and Vp is there. I'll be using this expression and this expression. Rather, I will be substituting the value of yx here, and then I'll be integrating for potential difference across the channel to get the final expression between ID and VDS on the next page. Now, let us complete the relationship between ID and VDS. Now, I have substituted the value of yx in terms of A and W. rather I am including the constant value A and constant value AP. Now this equation for current passing through the device, integrating with the appropriate limits, this is the equation. Further integration leads to this equation. At saturation, this VDS minus VGS is equal to VP, this is the cutoff voltage. And by using a little mathematical manipulation, we arrive at this point. This is the final equation for current passing through the device. We started initially with the gate potential at zero. By putting VGS zero, we arrive at this equation. Whatever is remaining, this is called saturation current. And at pinch of voltage, this is the maximum value of the current. And beyond pinch of, current doesn't increase beyond this value. This is the fixed value, and this is called saturated current. This is one more article about N-type JFET. We have already had the relationship between IIT and VDS. Now we can define mutual conductance of junction field effect transistor. Mutual conductance is the derivative of current with respect to VGS. And after derivation, we arrive at this equation. This is the equation for mutual conductance for junction field effect transistor. This equation has close resemblance with the square law. That's why the characteristics for JFET are not equally spaced. This is square law.